Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow, he knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear, and when the grain is ripe, he wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." And he said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, that when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yesterday, we meditated on the Ten Commandments as the standard, the moral standard, guidelines, rules of our life as Catholics. And we have summarized it into 10 values: fidelity to God, reverence to His name, and service to His glory, especially making holy the Sabbath day for us, Sunday. Then the value of the family of generation, meaning our parents, our reverence, obedience, and support of them. Then the value of life. Then we have the value of our body as temple of the Holy Spirit, purchased by the blood of Christ. Then we have the value of property. Respect the property of neighbors. Then the value of good reputation, thou shalt not bear false witness. And then the family of procreation. While the fourth is the family of generation, our parents. We do not choose our parents, God chose them for us. The family of procreation, you choose your wife, of course your children. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods, meaning do not destroy his households, his family, his wife, and his employment and property. 10 values, very important for the integrity and welfare of each individual, of the family, and of society in general. Violate it, and you will face the consequences. Make legislation against it. The next generation will suffer. Legalize adultery or divorce. You attack the very core of value of integrity and family. Allow corruption. Thou shalt not steal. do not prosecute those who are corrupt. Active and passive corruption. Active, you are the one doing it. Passive, you receive what is, like for example, bribery, it's also corruption. So very important instructions from the Creator of the world. Indispensable, inviolable values and rights of human person. Ang akong promise, malumpat-lumpat lang ako, depende sa issues nga importante sa sining days until March 2, which is as Wednesday. Pagka March 2, we'll focus on the public life of our Lord Jesus Christ, doctrinal again, His suffering, cross, in preparation for the Holy Week. Pero because it's on ordinary time now, ordinary season in our liturgical calendar, so we meditate on the moral principles based on the Ten Commandments. So nabutang diri parte sa life iniya. So fifth commandment, thou shalt not kill. Throughout the 20th century, Western civilization has witnessed a titanic struggle between two radically opposed philosophies of human life. The traditional sanctity of life ethic and the new quality of life ethic. So may tatlo ka pananawa, duha ka pananawan generally na hanungod sa kabuhi. Ang isa ka school, isa ka grupo, nagasiling life is sacred. So sanctity ang ila ginaproteksyonan sa life and basis of understanding of life. Sa pihak naman, hindi sanctity, kundi quality of life. Quality of life. Not sanctity, kundi quality of life ethic. The new morality judges human lives, meaning the quality of life ethic, judges human lives by the standard of quality, and by the standard, it declares some lives not worth living, and the deliberate termination of these lives is morally legitimate. Termination meaning killing is a euphemism for killing. The criteria by which a human life is most often judged in our time is quality of life ethic. Kagano ining quality of life ethic? Makita mo ni whether it is wanted by another. So today, this is unusually applied to unborn children to justify abortion. Because I do not want you, I can kill you. Because you affect my life. Maapektuhan karon ang akong life, ang quality sa mga utod mo, patyon ko na lang ikaw. So wala sang sanctity sang life, quality of life ang value, hindi sanctity. So kung hindi ka na mapuslan, kag hindi ka na kinanglanon, pwede ka mapatay. That's why we have the assisted suicide. Kaya hindi na siya mapuslan. Nagad ka da ka sakripisyo man, kundi injeksyonan ka na lang na patay ka. Munang subong, dira mo maintindihan na ng Katoliko iya sanctity of life, ang ilaya quality of life. If the baby is unwanted by the mother, because quality is, depends on the usefulness, okay? Sa isa katawo sa another person, sa society. If the baby is unwanted by the mother or predicted to be unwanted by society, then it is thought morally right to take that life. In other words, to kill it. In other places and times, other unwanted groups, not only the babies but groups, have been denied the right to life. Such as the Jewish people during Holocaust, colored people, and people with wrong political and religious beliefs. So kung hindi ta ka mapuslan sa ako niya partido, patyon ta ka.
Kung dita ka mapuslan sa akon nga programa, patyon ko ikaw. Kay ginadiminish mo ang quality of life ko. Kay ginadiminish mo ang quality of life sang society. So patyon ka. Sanctity, sanctity, wala sanctity. Quality. Next reason nga ang may quality of life ethic, whether it has too much pain. So kung nagasakripisyo ka kag too much pain, patyon ko na lang ikaw. Naluoy ako sa imo. Low ang quality sang imo life because nagasuffer ka sang cancer. Wala sang sanctity of life. Nagakita mo, nagasakripisyo ka na, nag-ano ka na da. Ah, patay na lang na. Whether it has too much pain. Today, this is usually applied to justify killing the old. But there's increasing pressure to justify and legalize medically assisted suicide at any age. See, intindihan nato na, dirigal-igali ng sosyedad. Kalidad, gali isang kabuhay ang gina-desire nila. Siyempre, kung may cancer, kagadunot ka da, anong quality isang life mo? Another reason sang ining quality of life ethic, whether it is severely handicapped mentally or physically. So kung buangit na, ti anong quality isang life na sinakibuang na? Nga nga sinagad mo kagasto ang kwarta sa gobyerno da. Kung physically ka handicap na kagbulag, ina kagano da, hindi man na mapuslan, hindi man na ganansyahan, hindi man nakaubra, tanan mo na nga sweldo da, ginano mo da, hindi mo na nila ipagpatyon. Bata mo nang abnormal, o drug addict, nagagkay mo pang abudlay, tanan mo nga sweldo da, ano mo na, papatay na lang na. Ga-diminish siya sang quality sang life ya, kag ikaw man, di ka ka-enjoy, di ka kalagaw. That's quality of life ethic. Too much pain. Unwanted. Hindi mapuslan. Naga-lower sang quality of life. Of the person himself, of the family around, and of society in general. Therefore, morally justifiable ang dispose sa ilang. Now, aton bilang Katoliko, the sanctity of life ethic. Dumdumon nato ni na Katoliko kita. Aton iya is sanctity of life ethic ya. The opposite philosophy of life is the traditional sanctity of life ethic, which is taught by all great religions of the world, is the basis of Western civilization from its Judeo-Christian roots, is presupposed in our laws, and is the basis of all Catholic teaching about the fifth commandment, thou shalt not kill. There are three reasons for the sanctity of life. Nga ginakinsider ang sanctity of life. Its origin, its nature, and its end. Human life is sacred because from its beginning, it involves the creation, the creative action of God. It came from God. And it remains forever in special relationship with the Creator. And the Creator is its sole end. So may hindi siya sa quality of life, kundi dito siya nagasandig sa purpose ng the one who created life. That's why kung nag-atheistic ang society, nag-quality of life ethic ang ginasunod niya. Kung wala sila gapati sa Dios, o hindi sila wala sila gapati sa Ten Commandments, o gina-disregard nila kay maapektuhan ng ila ya desire and interest, disregard nila ang sanctity of life, kag quality of life lang. That's why more nga nag-atheistic ang kalibutan kag materialistic, the more nga nagadamo support sa ang quality of life ethic.
God alone is the source of the Lord of life from its beginning until its end. No one can under any circumstance claim for himself the right directly to destroy an innocent human being. If this is not true, then life is not sacred and God is not God. If it is true, then the quality of life ethic is as serious a form of idolatry as the worship of stone idols, false pagan gods, or evil spirits, all of which is ancient times also manifested themselves in the practice of human sacrifice, especially children.
So kita naton sa thou shall not kill, ma-enlighten kita. So hindi pagkontrahon ng katoliko ato pagkatoliko, no? Ang origin sa aton understanding sa life, hindi iyaya sa person, kundi sa the one who loves the person, who created the person. The dignity is not in the person. The dignity is the one who loves the person. Bisan bulag na siya, kag hindi mapuslan, may dignidad na siya, kaya ang gapalangga sa iya, iloy. So hindi mo na pagpatyon kay bisan hindi na siya, wala na siya dignidad, hindi na siya mapuslan, pero ang love sang nagbunag sina, hindi mo mabakal, mo nang value ya. That's why sa aton, ang value sang human person is in the creator. Kuha ang creator, anong bilin siya? So, depende sa iya, quality lang. Pero kung may creator siya, o sanctity na, sang life. That's why lain ang perspective sang faith makontribute sa kalibutan. So I hope maka-enlighten ini sa aton, matamat nga mahangpan ini kag matun-an para nga ma-deepen nato ng aton understanding sang faith, and we have the power to explain the hope that is in us. So diri kita sa kalibutan, hindi kita friends ang kalibutan, hindi man kita enemies ang kalibutan, friend kita in some way. Enemy man kita sa kalibutan, kay mga Kristiyano kita, the world will hate you. Pero ang aton perspective permis ang aton life diri sa kalibutan is witnesses of faith. So kung friend, friend eh. Kung enemy, enemy. Pero witness kita sa faith naton kay Christ. That's the nature sa aton existence and life in this world. Di too much friendly sa world, or too much adversarial sa world. Part ina, pero witnesses sa kalibutan. Amo na ang aton pagtuo. Magtindog kita.
Brothers and sisters, let us now present to God the needs of the world and the needs of our community. We also pray for the repose of the souls of those unborn children, aborted, unwanted, and those rejected by society by reason of religion and colors and race and status. O God the Father, you give dignity and sanctity to our life because you are the Creator. O God the Son, you gave dignity to our life because you purchased it by your blood. And O God, O Holy Spirit, you keep that dignity because you continually sanctify us to prepare us for our final communication with the Blessed Trinity someday. Thank you for your actions and for your salvific power. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. The liturgy of the Eucharist.